always be tight. Memory every single day and night. Even when you start acting like a fool, you know I'm loving every single thing you do. Talk about, because we get this question, you know, asked frequently. Everybody wants to know
what it's like to be young parents of two. So, well, really one, but two to come.
Exactly. Yeah. We got two under two, you know, one on the way. Two under two. Firstly, let's just start off by saying that everything is mental. And just like I've been telling y'all, even like with pregnancy, because y'all are always saying how, oh my God, your pregnancies just always seem easy and, you know, you don't have problems, blah, blah, blah. And it's really just because it's mental. I have made up in my mind that it's going to be easy for me. I made up in my mind that how I want it to go is how it's going to go and it's going to work out for me. And that's just what happens, because that's the energy that I'm putting into the universe, and that's what the universe is giving back to me. So right now, at this current moment, I am 8 months pregnant. I am 8 months pregnant, and I do have a little one-year-old. And it's not that it's difficult, but it is that now that I'm 8 months, I do have to slow down a little bit more because I'm not able to be as active with him as I'm used to before I got this big. So that's just really the only thing that I'm dealing with. That may be, you know, not the same, is that I just can't run and play and jump around because I'm out of breath and tired at this point. But before I got to this 8 month mark, it was a breeze. Are you scared? What are the challenges? Can you afford this?
First of all, what made you come up with a two under two?
Somebody said it to me.
But I don't get it. Two under two.
Because it's two kids that are under two.
Okay. Makes sense. How do I feel about having two kids under two?
And you are young.
Okay.
You're young, like...
Well, first of all...
How are you going to afford this?
First of all, it's never too late and it ain't never too early. You know, it's all about God's time. And I ain't complaining with the choices I made and, you know, the blessings he done gave me, so...
This is what you wanted.
It is what it is, baby. I'm a family man. I'm ready for it. You put it on my plate, guess what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna eat. So, I ain't worried. You know, I come from a household of 9 kids total. So, we was a lot, you know what I'm saying? And the thing with that, you know, I was blessed to have those siblings. So I got a big family already. So if I ever need a hand, we got plenty. We got plenty hands. And it's not even that, because I'm all about mine. So I'm going to be right there with mine every step of the way. I'm not worried about struggling. I already did that. If I knew I was going to be struggling, I wouldn't have had no child.
Exactly.
I'm not worried about that. So I'm straight, and I'm going to always be straight. And I say that because you ain't gonna outwork me. Nah. I used to work 3 jobs. You know, I got crazy work ethic. You know what I'm saying? I got multiple streams of income. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
You ain't finna outwork me. I'm gonna bust my ass.
Okay.
Period. You know, my kids ain't gonna starve. I'll starve before they starve. You know what I'm saying? Period. Period. Yeah. But, two under two, it's a blessing, man. Like I said, I come from a big family, and that's what I want, you know. You love to see your seeds, like, growing, you know what I'm saying? And then on top of that, you know, I'm going to plant seeds, get them jewels, and it's just like it's a fresh start to create something and just give it the game and watch it grow, you know what I'm saying? Just watch it grow, a fresh start. Ain't nobody putting nothing in their head yet, so...
It's pure. It's a pure soul.
It's a pure soul. It's beautiful.
And this is what we wanted. We wanted to have two together so that they can grow up together.
Honestly, She wanted a girl. So she wanted to try again.
Whatever. That's not true.
That's what it was.
No, I did want a girl, but I also, I wanted a boy too. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, I wanted a boy first. Like, I keep telling y'all, I had a big brother. That's what I wanted. And I wanted my daughter to have a big brother, but I also wanted them to be raised together. Because yeah. Bless was lonely. Like,
was
I didn't,
lonely.
He was so lonely, and he still be lonely. We played with him, but you know, when he gets around other kids, he's just so excited. And we don't have him around, like, you know, he's not in school or anything, so it's better to be raised with your siblings.
Yeah.
So he needs somebody to play with. And also, you know, we're getting older, and he's just young.
Come on in, Bless.
And he's young, so, like, we're not gonna be able to, you know, always have his back. Like,
come give me some love. Can I get some love?
So his sister is gonna be like two peas in a pie, because that's how we're gonna raise them. And they're gonna always be able to have each other's backs.
Say what up, vlog! Say what up, vlog! Bless hasn't had a bottle in 2 days, by the way. The man growing, right? Yeah. Well, he hasn't had formula, you know. We just been giving him something to drink and food, real food.
Yeah, he's been eating breakfast, lunch, and dinner. No formula.
He probably starving.
He's not starving. He's been doing good. And he hasn't even, like, waking up in the middle of the night, like, wanting a bottle. So, which is good. He's broken out of that. Like, he doesn't wake up in the middle of the night at all. So I'm just glad he's broken out of that. So then all we got to focus on is the girl. When she comes,
speaking,
she's going to wake
speaking
up.
Speaking of
look, you thirsty? It's more in here.
Oh, but, yeah, man. 2 under 2. Hey. God, and, you know, next year.
2 under 2, and it's 2 raising them.
Next year might be 3.
No.
Nah, I'm gonna tell you right now, we're gonna slow our roll right now.
Okay, so the fact that you're young, do you feel like, you know, having kids young stopped you from anything? Like, do you want to be in the club? You want to go party with your friends?
You interviewing me?
Yeah, I'm interviewing you. Because these are the questions that they ask. So,
well, check this out. I'm an old soul, 1. 2, I done already did that. I done had my fun. I've been in the club since I was 15.
Okay.
And guess what I was doing in the club? Making money. Excuse my French. I was making money. I was shooting. I was taking pictures. I did whatever I had to do. Because like I said, I don't come from the sweet side of town. You know what I'm saying? Where we got it made. And we ain't had nada. You know what I'm saying? So I had to go get my dollars. I had to go hustle and do what I had to do. So all that playtime, oh, I had fun. When I first made some good money, oh, I had my fun. I done bought cars. I done bought clothes. I done went to the club, paid for bottles. I stood on a few couches. That's what they do, right? I did all that. So, I mean,
it's old to us. And the thing is that we just did it. So it's just like, you know, what's next, you know?
I want more out of life. You
exactly.
Know what I'm saying? And I don't want to wait till I'm 30 or 40 or 50 to, you know, start a family. I don't want to wait till then. Tomorrow ain't promised.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I want to live my life now.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I want to start my family now. I want to grow with my family. It's me investing my time, me investing my hard work, me investing my money, me investing all this energy into something that's can give it back. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it's about with me, at least. Now, everyone's entitled to their own opinion. You know what I'm saying? Everyone might be on a different type of time. You know what I'm saying? Something might work better for you. But this will work for me and mine.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And that's how it is, man.
And that's another thing people gotta watch out for is time. Because I feel like a lot of people live as if they got another life. Like, no, this is your only life. And who's to say that you're going to make it to 30? We don't know. Like, we don't know when it's our time.
Well, I mean, hope you're going to make it. I wouldn't say all that. Because I would live not worried about 30.
I mean, you ain't gotta worry about that, but I'm just saying, as far as going back to like live now, you know, don't put time limits on what you're trying to do with your life. Like, don't be like, oh, I'm gonna do this when I turn 30.
But look, here go the thing. A lot of people, you know, and this is, you know, ain't nothing wrong with it. A lot of people, they plan out their life, you know, like to go in that order. You know what I'm saying?
I wanna go. But it doesn't always work.
But it ain't about what worked for you. It might work for them. Okay. You know what I'm saying? It might work for them. They plan out their life. They go to school. They do this. They do this. They do that. You know, they checking off a bucket list. You know what I'm saying? When it comes to people like me, and there's a lot of people like me. I'm spontaneous. I'm impulsive. I want it now, and I want mine.
Impulsive.
I want what's owed to me. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't gonna get on that topic. You know what I'm saying about what's owed to me, because a lot of y'all know. Y'all know, I ain't gonna say too much. I want mine and I want it now, so I'ma bust my ass to go get it. I'ma put 120, I'ma put 200, 300 in. I'ma put all my energy into getting what I want out of my life, you know? I'm the CEO of my life, you know what I'm saying? And you are too, you're the CEO of your own life, you know what I'm saying? Move accordingly. So like I said, it's just that I want to live my life now, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people grow up and they want the white picket fence and the family and the, you know, the boy, the girl, and the perfect wife. And I wanted that too. So what I'm waiting for?
Yeah, you got that.
What am I waiting for? You know what I'm saying? So I went and got it, made it happen, and I'm going to continue to work and build with them and instill the same type of energy into them. You know, work for what you want now. You can relax and retire later. I'd rather club at 40, 50, and 60 than to be busting my ass at 30, 40, 50, 60.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I'd rather be with my children chilling, and they is at my age now. You know what I'm saying?
And again, this is just what works for us. This, you know, is our life. This is what we chose. And everybody's different.
Everybody's different, you know?
Yeah.
But like I said, it worked for me, and it feels great. I love being young and being able to run around with my child. Children, I'm gonna be able to run around with them, do what I can do, have fun. You know what I'm saying? Bam. You feel? I don't want to be 30, 40, 50. Like I said before, I'm trying to do that. I want to be 30, 40, 50, and we out on vacation somewhere. You know what I'm saying? Chilling. And they can add food to the table as well with their hustles and whatever else they might do. You know what I'm saying? But to each his own. God bless you all. You know, to each his own.
So I have another question.
What's that?
How does your family feel about you being young and having two children?
Boy, let me tell you. First of all, my mama had me at 16, okay? So she was young. And
my mom
had
me at 17.
So yeah. They didn't want us to go down that same road that they went on. So at first, they were like, oh, hell no. You know, they weren't with the children thing. They weren't with the, you know, doing this and that. But see, my mama, she couldn't say much once I hit 18. When I hit 18, I was damn near on my own. I ain't gonna go into detail. I won't give everybody too much detail. But, cause I can go back to when I was 15. You know what I'm saying?
You just let them know you've been bossed up.
I've been working for a long time. Just now I've been paying bills for a long time. Anywho, so my mama was pretty comfortable with me making these type of decisions because she know I was very responsible growing up, and I'm very responsible now. It hasn't stopped and it won't stop, you know. I take care of my business and I take care of mine. When I say mine, that means mine, my family, my everything, my career, my job, my car, my, you know what I'm saying? Take care. So yeah, she was happy, she was proud, and she said it wasn't gonna be easy, but I like a challenge.
Right. And as for my family, my mom, she was happy because she felt like I was in a great position as far as, you know, I'm an entrepreneur, I have a great man, we are together, and we're having a child together. One thing my mom didn't want is for history to repeat itself, because my mom was a single mother, and she didn't want me to have a child by someone who I wasn't gonna be with. So, but she loves Seth dearly, and she loves our relationship, so she was just all for it.
That's another thing, man. I feel like a lot of relationships, when it comes to these type of decisions, y'all gotta be eye to eye. Y'all gotta be able to work things out for the greater good. You know what I'm saying? Don't be selfish when it comes to stuff like this. You know, this is important stuff that two.
You need to.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a balance, as most would say. It's never about one or the other. You know, it's about
you guys as a unit.
It's about being a unit.
When raising a child.
Definitely when raising a child, you know. That child wants his mother, he's gonna need his mother. That child wants his father, and he's gonna need his father. A lot of y'all ain't got your father. Some of y'all.
I ain't have mine.
Some of y'all ain't got your mother. You know what I'm saying? And God bless you at the end of the day, because someone real close to me don't have a mother nor father. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Somebody had to step in and be that.
But you can't allow situations like that to defeat you, you know?
Don't let nothing defeat you.
No. Exactly.
Boss so, up. Break the cycle.
Break the cycle. That's all it's about.
Be the example. The cycle. Break the cycle. Be the example. Trust me, I definitely broke the cycle in my household.
And so I'm
a,
did I.
And I'm going to be the example. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to work. That's my challenge to myself. You should be able to motivate yourself to do what you need to do. You should be the motivation in the example for the life that you want to live. You know what I'm saying? Period. No excuses. There's no excuses. Don't care what situation you may have came through. God put you through it to get through it. So, you feel?
So yeah, that's gonna wrap up this video. We basically just wanted to give you guys, answer, you know, some questions that y'all been asking. So I like fake interviewed Sid. but to also encourage you guys, cause there are a lot of young people who watch us who may have children. They're, you know, not, and you know, everybody's situation is different. So we just wanted to give you guys a little motivation, no matter what you're going through, no matter if you have four or five kids, if you have one kid, whatever it is, mind over matter, it's positivity and it's love. Just as long as you can give your child love, you're good.
Single mothers, single fathers.
More power to you.
Like, you can do it.
You can definitely do it.
It's definitely possible. You know what I'm saying? It's all, like I said, you're the CEO of your life. You know what I'm saying?
You are in full control.
Fire and promote accordingly. You know what I'm saying? If the mother didn't step up, you could find a mother to step up to the plate. You know what I'm saying? Just a good person, and that's a good example as well. Vice versa, you could find a good man that's going to step up to the plate. It is what it is. It's about being a unit. It takes a village to raise a child, period. You know what I'm saying? It takes a village. It takes what they see. You know what I'm saying? But I ain't going to say too much, though. You know what I'm saying? I ain't going to say too much.
But thank you guys so much for watching. We hope you love the video. Make sure you hit that subscribe button to join the family and become one of our cousins.
You did. Good. At the end of the day, it's all love. It's all us. It's a family thing. What? You and me will always be tight. Family every single day and night. Even when you start acting like a fool, you know I'm loving every single thing you do.